Today, our special guest for the Live Limitless show is Dr. Shirish Patil. And Dr. Shirish Patil is, he's having a very high, or his key interest area is health and hospital administration, with special emphasis on planning and implementation and monitoring of the various areas of, running a hospital. And he's also a member of the John Maxwell team in the USA, and he's an active Rotarian and a member of the Rotary International District for the past 25 years, and has served the district in many, many capacities and many different ways. And he's the past president of Rotary Club of Navi Mumbai Hillside, Navi Mumbai Hillside Rotary Club. And he's also a voracious reader and fond of reading personal development books. So with this quick introduction, I would like to welcome Dr. Shirish Patil to the 321 Limitless show. Welcome to the show, Dr. Shirish.
Thank you.
As we all know that the format of this interview series is going to be in the 3-2-1 phases, which means the first section, I'll be asking three questions to Dr. Shirish. Let me start with the first one. Dr. Shirish, like I know, along with your personal and professional development, you're a big fan of personal and professional development as well. So what did you do and what measures did you take for your personality development all these years?
Well, Ram, I think it was in 1982, a friend of mine, his name is Harshad. Today, he's a leading gastroenterologist in the city of Bengaluru. He gave me a book, The Treasury of Courage and Confidence by Norman Vincent Peale. This book, Ram, The Treasury of Courage and Confidence by Norman Vincent Peale, was the first ever self-help book I read in my life. That was way back in 1982. Since then, I read most of the books of Norman Vincent Peale. I studied the works of Napoleon Hill, Jack Canfield, Mark Victor Hansen, Bob Proctor, John Maxwell, Brian Tracy, and many authors. Most of these authors are pillars of the personality development industry in the world. I make it a point to attend at least one live session of one of these authors in a year. And over the period of years, Ram, I have internalized the time-tested techniques and proven methodologies taught by these authors through their recordings, through their audiobooks, and I make it a point to use these techniques and methodologies in my day-to-day living.
Awesome. So that's the secret of personality development. That is, first of all, reading books and also going attending seminars, meeting new people, consuming new information. Fantastic, doctor. True. And I also know that I relate with you very much, because I too took the same journey as you. And and we are also so fortunate that we saw a lot of transition and a lot of changes in our lifetime. Like we came from the landline phones now to the satellite phones. So we saw so many changes. So my second question would be to ask you, Dr. Shirish, like how did you transition yourself from a world where everything used to be manual, like without any computers, but today we are surrounded by technology, computers, sensors everywhere. So how did you go through this transition, Doctor? What was your experience?
Ram, initially I was technologically challenged. Even today, I'm not comfortable with click and enter on this keyboard. But over a period of time, I've learned to adapt and adjust to the technological change which has happened around us. I decided to take this change in a positive way. Change is something which is very constant. Change is one of the laws of life. And I decided to consider this particular change and modify myself to become a master of this technological change rather than to become a slave of this technological change. It has been a learning process, Ram, over the period of years. Even today, this very Zoom platform, I'm trying to learn how to operate Google Meets, Microsoft Teams and different kinds of platforms. Everybody wants a different platform. And the best thing, Ram, is that I have been blessed and I am happy that I lived in this particular era where I got to see the best of both the worlds, a world without computers and a world with computers, like a world without without mobiles and a world with landline, what you said just now. It is more or less the same thing. Your generation and my generation, I think, are the best. The next generation will not get to see these particular things.
Very well said, sir. Yes, absolutely. See, the way we work, the way we talk to each other, the way we communicate, this was not possible like 20 years ago, like sitting in two different cities and having a video call like this was unimaginable. We thought it was only magical to do so, but that magic is normal today. So we don't know. Right. I believe, Doctor, that we are in the most abundant phase of humanity ever. Of course, there is this corona, other things are going on, but that is right. Part of life will go away. And there are warriors like you who are fighting corona like anything. Right. And I'm sure we'll be able to easily come out of it. Which brings me to the next question, Dr. Shirish. Like, what is your, is there any unfulfilled dream that you badly want to fulfill in the next few months or years, perhaps?
Yes, Ram. One of the most important dream which I have, which I've not been able to fulfill so far, is to have my body of work and to write nonfiction books. Now, though this desire has been lingering with me for quite some time, somehow because of professional commitments, I have not been able to carve out and block that amount of time which will help me to fulfill this particular desire. But that impulse to create my body of work, that strong desire is already there. And with this, you'll be happy to know that immediately after this post-COVID period is over, I'll be publishing my very first book on communication skills with the help of Stardom Publishers. And definitely, I'll get back to you. That is one of the things when with this body of work or with my nonfiction books, I would like to continue contributing to this world in making this world a better place in which to live, even after I'm past, dead, and gone. So I look forward to Stardom Publishers to help me into fulfilling this desire of mine.
Absolutely, Dr. Shiri. And let me also ask you, because we started this topic of coming up with your book and your advice. So what would be one or two pieces of advice that you want to give to all of us here right away that we can just take and and make use of? Like two pieces of advice or two tips?
We'll call this suggestion, Ram.
Okay.
One of the suggestions is we live in this high-tech digital world, this new age era, what we call as the screen age. All of us, whether it's the youth or the children or everybody, is on some form of the screen, the mobile phone or a tablet or a computer or some other device. And it is very essential for us in this high-tech world to keep ourselves away from these devices for a brief period of time every day and undergo some process of digital detoxification. This is very important. There was a study done in Massachusetts in which children who use digital devices just before going to bed were studied, and it was found that these children had disturbed sleep patterns, and they showed that changes in the sleep cycle. There was another study done by Radiology Society of North America. In fact, a paper was presented in that particular society in which young people who use digital devices and internet continuously were found to produce changes in their brain chemistry. Hmm. So there are many such examples, and therefore it is essential that we disconnect with our digital devices for some period of time and reconnect and refocus with social, real life interactions and meaningful relationships. Now, with these social interactions, meaningful relationships, we will help to minimize the stress which comes with a desire for continuously being connected in this digital world. So that would be one of the suggestions, a digital detoxification for a brief period of time every day. Another suggestion I would like to have is that we are on this planet for a very brief period of time. We are spiritual beings having a human experience, and we are not going to be here on this planet forever. Today, in fact, at this very moment, Ram, the solar eclipse is going on. I think people in Rajasthan, Uttarakhand, Dehradun are witnessing the solar eclipse. These phenomena will keep happening. We are not going to be here forever. So it's very essential that whatever time we have on this planet, we spend quality time with our family members, live life to the fullest. And I think that's also the theme of your very show, to live life limitless.
Limitless. Thank you, Doctor. And it's so interesting that you just turn the things around. What people usually believe was human beings, like human body, we are in the body in experiencing spiritual life, and you just turned it around. So we are spiritual beings experience the human body. You just turned it around in a fantastic way. That's a new perspective, I would say. Thank you so much. And Doctor, at this part of this interview, I would like to ask you, like before we end the show, I wanted to get your recommendation or a key resource that you have used and you have found really useful that you recommend all of us here to use it. What would that be? One or two key resources or the top key resources.
Ram, I'm using this Evernote app continuously for many years now, and it has helped me. And it works on all the platforms for me, whether I'm on my laptop or on my mobile or on my desktop in the office or at home. It works seamlessly across all the platforms. So this Evernote app has helped me a lot. And it helps me to remain a bit organized, mainly in my professional life. And there's a new feature which has come for a few years now, the speech to text version. So you just dictate it. Now, for people like me who are not comfortable with the keyboard, just speak it out and it types out and does its job properly. Many apps have come, but I've stuck to Evernote because that was one of the initials one which I came and I continued with it.
Fantastic. Yeah, I have used Evernote as well. It is a fantastic productivity tool, I would say. All right. Doctor, thank you so much for spending some time with us on the show. And thanks for sharing your perspectives, your insights, and your suggestions, and all, and also sharing this very cool resource that we all can use in our daily lives as well, a productivity tool. And we'll be looking forward for your book. And I'm sure your book will have plenty of resources and key ideas and big ideas like this that we can take and implement, because it is, I see that it is coming from an experienced person, a medical doctor, an entrepreneur, and who was also running a medical hospital, like a huge one, plus coming from the personal and professional development industry as well. And I'll be looking forward to read your book, and so will be all our viewers as well. Thank you so much for joining us on the show.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ram. Thank you.